There's not much more Danton can say. He's got a girl in a leather coat. She always walks ahead while he's so busy thinking. Back at home, he's got paper and pencil. But standing under an overcast sky with nothing ahead and nothing behind reminds him of how little else he's got to say. Someday, he'll drop his eyes from every rock. He'll drop his eyes from every rock. Or tree, rather, as the quote would go for him. He won't care. But at least he'll always have his girl in the leather coat. His father had farmed Christmas trees. Once a year for 1 month, his father got paid. Danton thought back then that that was the coolest thing, to earn your entire year's wages in 1 month of each year, and then the rest of the time was spent on faith, for what if December never came again? So Danton had took to the trees as well, as it were. He studied them. The speaker is actually unsure what fellows are called who study trees, but Danton became one of those, say, an arborist. He was an arborist. He wrote articles on trees for scientific magazines, but he immediately began to run out of words. He says, there's just not much more I can say about trees. Why is there a pit with stone walls here? He'd think when he was supposed to be out studying trees. He was sort of more interested in how humans intruded into the woods. Sometimes people would build things in the woods, and even though Danton spent all his time in the woods, he'd go by something or another that humankind had built, and he'd think, now what the hell is that? Thank goodness he had a girl in a leather coat, though she sometimes just wore a colored shirt when it was hot. Okay, he thought, pay attention to the trees. He'd already spoken everything about them, though. They didn't beat a medieval bridge. That was man incurring on the forest back then. Man had left the forest, Danton always thought, but then man began to want back into the forest. It was like the joke about the cows that always so puzzled Danton. Two cows are walking in a field. The two cows are brothers, and so they're always fighting. And this particular day, they're fighting over who gets the bale of hay that got lost off the farmer's truck round back of the barn, and the farmer hadn't noticed the bale had gotten lost, so the bale was up for grabs. So the two brother cows were arguing over who got to eat it, and they're arguing and arguing and arguing along, and suddenly one says, wait a minute, do we even eat hay? Or the same with the joke about the sheep. Sure, Danton saw where they were funny jokes, but he didn't see why he should laugh out loud at them, and he honestly felt the same way about his job with the trees. He didn't think that much of trees, and he just didn't have enough to say about them that would last the rest of his career. It was enough to make him walk in open fields. What he really wanted was heartbreaking sunsets. Now those he could write articles about, but no one studied heartbreaking sunsets for a living. There weren't enough magazines dedicated to the study of sunsets. There weren't any weathermen, he supposed, studied sunsets, but then weathermen also had to study a lot of other bullshit. I want to just study just heartbreaking sunsets, Danton thought. And if the day is cloudy, I want to do nothing more than think about the beautiful bum of my girl in the leather coat. I needn't have to be able to talk always of trees.